Hello! Here's a quick tip to correct odd-looking shading that you might see in your viewport in Maya 2018 or above. If you made the switch to a newer version of Maya and you loaded up an existing scene, you might notice that something doesn't quite look right with your shading. You might get lines down the middle, or things might look flat and not really react to light nicely. Well, there's a simple fix for this. So we've got this great scene here provided by artist Paul Tosca, who shared this work online. The problem here is normal maps. By default, Maya treats all image maps as color maps, but if we look at a normal map, we know that this isn't color data. It tells Maya or other applications how to shade a particular point to give the appearance of detail. Lucky for us, this is an easy fix. So if you select the offending object, and you can go right-click Material Attributes, go right to the material, we'll find for this material where the normal map is plugged in. Usually it'll be in a bump mapping section or a normal mapping section. And we'll pop in there with the arrow button, and it'll take us to the file node, and we see we have a normal map and we have color space. And this is set to sRGB, which isn't correct. It's not color data. So we're just going to set it to raw. And you can see that gives us now nice results. And if I just rotate my key light here, and you can really see how nice that looks. Now, here's the thing. We don't want to have to do that for every object in our scene or every normal map in our scene, so I'm just going to set this back to the incorrect state and show you how to automate this. And you can really see the difference there. It doesn't look good. So I'm going to go to the preferences, the man running away from the gear, color management, and we're going to add a new rule here. So we have this add button. We'll call this normals. And if you notice in our files, usually a normal map will have underscore n, underscore normal, normal, nrm, some naming convention in the file name. If you're not doing that, you probably should. It'll make life a lot easier. Because we can do something like this. So in this rule, we're going to say any image extension that asterisk stands for wildcard or anything. Anything with underscore n and anything after that, so asterisk underscore n asterisk, gets assigned the color space raw. Okay, and so that's all we have to do, and then we can just hit reapply rules to scene, and you see immediately my lighting corrects, and we get some nice looking lighting, and our shading is correct. And if you look in the description below the video, you'll see I have a pointer to the docs that explain how to automate this studio-wide, so you don't have to worry about it. But in the meantime, now you know how to fix this problem, and knowing is 2/4 of the battle. Have a good day.